Yeah, everything that's happened in the past 18 months, it's been absolutely bonkers. Going from scoring Fortnite videos like they were music videos, to then having people know me for my music and actually like it, is crazy. Cause homeschooling, I wasn't going outside. So I thought I was just gonna be in Texas forever. But then boom.
Houston-based artist David Burke amassed over 100 million streams in only 17 years old.
No more second-guessing myself, though, because I second-guessed myself for Romantic Homicide, and that song almost never came out, so, yeah.
I've lived with him for like 15 years of my life.
Why am I still here?
He's pretty high.
I don't mean to be complacent.
Yeah, ever since I was young, I really just liked anime, gaming, and poetry. That's it. I remember reading my first manga when I was in fifth grade. Dragon Ball, Tokyo Ghoul, and see these fantasy characters with powers and all that, that weren't superheroes. It was the first time I've seen stories where people have powers or magical abilities without being like a superhero like Batman or Spider-Man or something like that. And that inspired me to start writing and write my own stories about them.
Poetry was a big part of my life, and it's the reason that I make the music that I make. And I basically write a poem every day.
I've always wanted to be a professional video game player.
I forgot how good I was at this game, bro.
And I was in Team Assault, Team Delirium, and Team Limit. So I'm playing my video games, I'm thinking I'm gonna make good money, and then I see all of these red money signs on my YouTube account. So I was making $0. I was getting copyright striked left and right, left and right.
Because of his ability, I know he's able to play and do, so I said, just make your own music. And that was that.
Here With Me I made as like a cover up for Romantic Homicide because I got in my own head about it. I thought Romantic Homicide was the worst song I ever made. I got bored and was like, okay, I got this song. Let me just see what happens. And I posted a snippet on TikTok, and then Romantic Homicide actually went insane. At the time I didn't have producers, nothing like that to go to. So I was like, I turned to online and I looked up indie type beats, and this producer named Dan Darmawan came up. There was one, I instantly gravitated to it. I downloaded it. Sent it to my phone, loaded it up on BandLab, got up from the computer. Where are my recording headphones at? Got up from the computer, ran to my studio. Now, if you take a look around, this is my little sister's room. And this happens to be my little sister's closet. I do not have a walk-in closet.
I know I would go upstairs and he would be sitting, he would be in a closet making music, and he said, oh, I'm making music for myself. And I was like, okay.
Sound isolation, insulation right there. The ropes, all your sound, it's going right there, boom, 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 right?
That closet is right over our bedroom, so every time he goes in there, we know.
I'm scared. I was like, okay, that sounds kind of good.
It feels like you don't care.
And then I stopped. Because I was like, bro, this could potentially go somewhere. I went back. You can see the vocal tracks and stems here.
I'm scared.
So overnight, I literally just threw this up. How do you get your band lab to sound like this? This sounds like studio, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And as soon as I saw this, I posted it. And after that, it just went stupid.
News: David breaks the top 40 with his single Romantic Homicide, which he reportedly recorded.
And I got all these emails from the record labels, and I didn't know what to do. I told my parents about it, and they thought I was getting scammed.
He came downstairs one night, and we were in the kitchen, and he said, I have something to tell y'all. I was like, what? He was like, this label. I was like, keep calling, and labels went. I was like, we were like, what are you saying? Boy, stop playing.
I thought it was a scam. I said, listen, David, just be careful who you're talking to. There's a lot of things going on online. until we flew to LA. It's like, okay, that's just kind of, this is reality. This is not a scam. This is a...
Yeah. We literally found out when labels started calling. That's it. Tell me that I'm not enough. Shut up, cause I gave myself fear. Walk in the
dark, can't find my way. We are at the Rise at the Warehouse in Houston, Texas. This is the parkour spot. Yeah, brought you guys because this is a big part of the story. Especially, I mean, not just in music, but in life in general, because I learned a lot of good lessons.
When David gets into something that he wants to do, he becomes very focused.
But I always, I mean, my dad forced me to do something like, what's it called? Yeah, some kind of disciplinary outlet.
Growing up as a kid, I'm a martial artist, training martial arts for 20 plus years. So the same work ethic and discipline that I had growing up, I wanted to reinforce that in David and Caleb.
Him just seeing them go so hard, he literally would just start training. He's like, you know what, man? I got to set an example, too. They think I'm old. I'm going to show them. Like, I got it in me. I still got it. Like,
a good way to get out the house. I mean, because I was homeschooled, so I was like, I'm not getting out the house.
I always wanted to kind of ask him what was going on. I didn't know that he was homeschooled, but I could see the shift in his energy. You know, I've always kind of noticed when he would come in, his headphones on. It was just the fact that I think he also kind of felt disconnected.
Transitioning from public school to homeschool is tragic. I thought I had a lot of friends in middle school. And then after being homeschooled, nobody's hitting me up. Nobody's asking me, like, where am I at? Why am I not coming to school today? It made me question, like, what is a real friend? And do I have any of those as well? I wrote the song Worthless based on that. It's like going on Fortnite and then finding more support from people that don't even know me, when people that I literally know didn't even care. It's pretty strange, bro. But it was cool because I found a lot of new passions, like just being alone and finding like my individuality, being myself. And being a nerd and watching anime and not being made fun of for watching anime or doing this and that and the third. Putting that emotion into the music because everybody's experiencing something at one point, and having people listen to that music is it's a beautiful thing. Today I brought you guys to Pentecostal West Houston. This is my church home here in Houston because it is almost, not almost, but is one of the most important parts of my life here.
You know, gospel music has been an integral part of our lives since the kids were very small.
It's still with me. Like, that's my main melodic influence for a lot of the stuff I do right now. Mm-hmm. And like gospel and classical as a whole. Just like, I love pianos. And so a lot of the new music I'm making has a lot of pianos in it. It's a lot of soul. So yeah, that's a big part, especially being a choir.
You help out quite a bit with our youth department here. Always so inclusive with all of the youth group. It's the ability that you have to connect with people.
Having experiences and knowing what the kids are going through, especially nowadays. So like being an anchor for kids that need like an outlet.
So the next time we see each other would probably be that August 11th show.
August 11th?
Yeah.
I went from never going to a concert. The first concert I went to was my own in February 17th. And now I'm going on a 50-show tour.
Playing live shows is probably one of the best parts about being an artist. It's like you can see the people that listen to your music face-to-face and see how much it connects. I think it's the most beautiful thing ever when they're involved in it as well. Like, they know the lyrics, they're singing back to you. It's like they're performing to you at the same time, so.
very proud in the fact that David's music helps people look beyond what they're going through and helps them to overcome what issues that they're having.
I make music for the people to take whatever they need from it. I don't push a specific, like, oh yeah, I said this in this song, that means that's the only thing it could possibly be about. But nah, I just make music, and if you need whatever you need from that song that you can apply to your own situation, I feel like my job is done, to be honest with you. So my goal is just to keep making better music.
David, stay focused, keep your heart pure, and keep your morals, and don't change for anyone. Love ya.
I'm scared.